Boy, isn't he? That's gonna be bluey. It's a bad boy. Bad boy, bad boy. Now, is a bit of a funny one, this one. By the way, welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry K. This is an American double IPA. 9.2%. Whoa, it's a funny stamp looking thing. It's from the Brew Dog Boys. This is under the label of Tesco's Finest, and it's kind of a Brewdog thing. I'll tell you why this is mixed up blues. I'll tell you why this is mixed up, because I've always looked on an IPA as a kind of an empire thing from the old British Empire from way back, where they used to send Indian Pale Ale. It was got its name from Indian Pale Ale, where they used to send Pale Ale over to India, and they used to heavily op it in order that they didn't have to have an IABV to get the troops mangled, you know. So that's kind of my look on what an IPA was, isn't it? But you've then got an American IPA, so that's kind of one taken one apart. Then it's got a strong ABV, so that's kind of gone in another direction. And then it's from lads in Scotland, so it's kind of wee proper mixed up. And I'm going to open it with a Canadian BB butterfly, and you got an Englishman drinking it. I don't know, whatever next, eh? Right, kind of a plain black cap on this one. So I don't know why I'm focusing in on it. It's a plain black cap, which is cool. I like that. It kind of means business. I do like the pretty ones. It means business. What are we going to have this one in? I've got a couple of glasses. I'm going to have it in my Blackfriars glass. That's what I'm going to do. Because I didn't get anything sent down to me from Brewdog. This is, as I said, I've got this in Tesco's, so I don't do Tesco's glasses. Tesco's don't send stuff down to you. Worse luck, and get me shopping. Oh, I say, look at that. It's ever so slightly cloudy, but that's never been a bad thing. Unless you've got chunks of Swede and carrots and cucumbers and all sorts, it's never a bad thing. That's very pretty looking, kind of ruby and that, you know, it's nice. Good lord. Wowza, wowza. You're getting some weird smells off of that. What's it say? What hop were you using here? Kind of straight away you're getting like tangerine-y, no. Yeah, you're getting strong tangerine. You're also getting blood orange in there. You're getting lots of citrusy notes. I don't think it says fresh whole flower hops. They would be added late for the aromas. It doesn't say what one they are though. Well, that should be cool. Amarillo, maybe, I don't know. Right, let's have a... Do you know what? You could sit and sniff this all bloody night. It's a gorgeous sniff. Let's have a taste. Oh, that is gorgeous. As you drink it, though, you get a whack right in the on the tongue as the alcohol hits, and as them a lot of them hops it. But at the same time, that's them citrusy notes lift it, really lift it up. Usually, you get a balance of, why am I shouting these? Usually, you get a balance of malt and hops, and you get those kind of toffees and hops in it. There's, I can't really taste any malt in this. I can't kind of get capture any malt. There may be a kind of a little bit of maybe a Munich or maybe crystal malt or something like that. But there's not a lot of malt going on, not on your tongue and or on the aroma, but citrus, wowza! But I tell you what, as heavy as that is, you could really, really have a lovely, lovely drink with it. Obviously, be careful. I would have one if I was you. You know, don't be going wee and frying them back, because it will go down sweet as anything, sweet as nectar. But you will get mangled on 9.2 quite quickly. Oh, and I'll tell you something else. That shot in the eye, that did. Oh, so loaded with flavours. Brewdog are really getting their game, really getting their game in order, I tell you. They are so getting their game in order. They kind of started out and they almost was like a, almost a bit of a clown outfit in there. You know, when they started, it seemed as if they was just out to shock. But you know what? It's pushing them margins of kind of not only showed other people the way, but they've kind of shown themselves the way, I believe. Because they've pushed their margins and they've come up with a few beauties. The 5 a.m. I had the other day was absolutely gorgeous. This is absolutely wonderful. It's a lovely, lovely drink, and it deserves a label of finest. It's under Tesco's finest. You'll see it in that serious looking thing. I hope they keep this on after the supermarket decided to leave it off. You know, it's the same sort of thing that happened with, I think it was Golden, no, the Bengal Lancer. Bengal Lancer was one of the, I think it was a Swedish, was it Swedish supermarket? Somewhere anyway. One of the supermarkets way away from, long way away from home, for me anyway, decided that they didn't really want the Bengal Lancer anymore, and Fuller's went, we'll have it, and that's a beautiful drink, another IPA. But this is an absolute outstanding drink, it really is. Be careful with it though. Thank you very much indeed. Well, I bought and paid for it, so I shouldn't be thanking them. But listen, thank you very much indeed for brewing it, Brewdog boys. Absolutely fantastic. Oh, gorgeous stuff. And I'm going to knock that down, I think, because it's beautiful. Listen, thanks for following us. Thanks for subbing. Thanks for friending. Thanks for friending me on Facebook. Thanks for following me on Twitter. Just thanks for kind of liking the videos and everything, and for just kind of helping to bring good beers into the attention of the drinking public, because we all need a little bit of help, and I hope I'm doing that for you guys out there, you know, because I get it done with me as well. I watch other people. Pardon me. Woo! That's lovely. Listen, get yourselves one of these. Brewdog IPA, American Double IPA. It is a mixed up drink. But it is absolutely gorgeous. go for it. Get one. Try it. Thank you very much. Terry K for Beer Goggles Reviews. Thank you.